What is happening, guys? Mark Martin's back again. You know where we are, so let's get into it. So guys, I'm recording this on the fly because again, setting up the studio is not an easy task. Sometimes it's getting a little bit too late and it's very difficult to put all the lights up and everything else like that. But as things happen, as things grow, who knows, at some point I will have a studio dedicated room or a room dedicated to a studio. We will see what happens. Anyway, so this is a follow-up to my initial first impressions of this one. This is obviously, I mentioned before, I don't know if you can see it on there because there's a lot of lighting is just not right about now, but I'm trying my best in the circumstances. So Montsouris, so ultimately that's a place in Paris. And when I checked it out, for some reason, I took it to say that it meant mountain smile, but it's actually literal translations like mountain mouse. So, you know, it's a place, but hey, I don't know the origin of that particular name. Nonetheless, guys, this one here, as I say, $19.99. Had it on now for most of the day. The bottle is here. As you can see, this is 100ml. And again, with this type of brown juice, you do get a bit of a description about the fragrance itself as well on the back. And again, $19.99, 100ml. I understand it's an eau de parfum concentration. Now, for me, guys, I've sprayed this one now. I've had a smell of it. I know you guys have mentioned about Baccarat Rouge and this type of elements where it's got this sort of, how could I say, grapefruit note or something else in there. Now, when I looked on for a Grantica, again, there's reference to praline in there, also with, I believe it's like a macaroon and then obviously lavender. The note on the actual box, the notes on the box, does say that it has grapefruit, amber and cedarwood. Now, I picked up on a particular scent in here, which is, I want to say a musk, and then when I looked on Fragrantica, it's saying it's musk. But if it's not musk, then it's going to be like a, how could I say, it's going to be like a ambroxan note in there. And that's ultimately what I pick up on. So the opening, yes, you do get the type of saffron, cinnamon, sort of almond vibe, a little bit compared to Baccarat Rouge 540 with Francis Curtis Jean. But at the same time, guys, the dry down, it starts to, so the top notes seem to be slightly more Baccarat Rouge. Then we get this lavender note, which seems to be borderline even like a medicine type of smell to me. It's not necessarily the most pleasant smell that I've smelled, in all honesty. But then the dry down seems to take it towards this, as I say, this ambroxan musk note. Now, for me, guys, and this is my personal opinion on my nose, what I pick up on, I was thinking, what does this remind me of? It reminds me of something. I couldn't quite get to it. Now, the ambroxan note I want to pick up on, on this particular fragrance does smell similar, if anyone else has smelled it, to, funny enough, German fragrance Office One or Office for Men. I can't remember top of my head what it's called now. Office One or Office for Men, whichever one it's called. There's an ambroxan note in that one that's quite prominent, and that's what I pick up on here. Now, this is, don't get me wrong, this is mixed again with that lavender note, so you get a sort of like more of a sort of chilled out element with a little bit of a spice, maybe some grapefruit as well. But I believe this is definitely a unisex fragrance. What keeps it maybe borderline going along the male side is this ambroxan note, which is pretty much there in the base. You will get wafts of sweetness. The opening is quite sweet, in all honesty, but also you do get a bit of a alcoholic sort of note, in my opinion, in the opening. It's not a bad fragrance. Is it worth $19.99? In my opinion, I'm gonna say no. I personally wouldn't necessarily purchase this again, put it that way. It's not like a repeat buy for me. It's one of those fragrances which, again, it's gonna fall into the back of my particular catalog of fragrances. Between this one and Nightport on 5 from Zara, if you really, really want something which is closer to Baccarat Rouge, I'm going to actually say it's gonna be the Nightport on 5. That's my opinion on it. I don't want to start getting into the different ones that have been recently released. Was it Red Temptation, different things like that. That's a slightly different ballpark. But just basing on these two previous fragrances, again, for first impressions, this is okay. It definitely, as I say, will give you that Baccarat Rouge vibe with this macaron, the macaron smell as well in there, with the sweetness and the opening. So again, slightly feminine to some extent, even floral to some extent in the opening, with that sort of like, I say, a saffron amber note. But then dry down takes it along the lines of a slightly more, I would say, slightly more borderline masculine with this ambroxan note or even musk. Longevity to my skin, probably lasting about, you get a bit of a scent bubble again for about an hour or so, hour to 2 hours. After that, I honestly just did not notice it. So that's just me. Now I'm in slightly more colder weather. In the high heat, I think this one will probably do a better job. Compared to what the juice looks like, it's probably more of a, say, more like a, maybe autumn, sort of like spring sort of fragrance is what I would say. It's not a winter fragrance in my opinion. It is slightly sweet, as I say, guys. So if you're not into Baccarat Rouge, and again, you do not like sweet fragrances, maybe this one isn't for you. It's definitely a unisex fragrance. Easily ladies could rock this one. But I just think it's one of those fragrances that, again, I've smelled it before. It's nothing, in my opinion, that's groundbreaking. Personally, you know, everyone's got a different perspective on it. Everyone's got a different price point on it. But for me, there's other fragrances where I would probably even spend maybe just £30 or so and get something that I probably would slightly more enjoy. It's okay. Maybe I'll sell this on eBay. Who knows? I'll see. Maybe give it some time. But as it goes, guys, between this one and Nightpot on 5, I personally prefer Nightpot on 5. Again, it's a slightly different direction that goes in. That's, in my opinion, slightly closer to Baccarat Rouge than this one is. This one has it in the opening, but then it goes its own way with its ambroxan and its sort of lavender note. Even borderline, even like an apple note in there I can pick up on. But it's not a bad fragrance, guys, all in all. But however, let me know and leave your comments down below. Is it worth £19 for you? Is it worth £20? Is it really? I don't know. Well, I know my opinions. Let me know yours, and I'll see you on the next video. Again, guys, as I want to say, if this is saving some time, some money, please don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe. Also, some of you guys ask me questions very directly. Some of you guys ask me questions also on the Instagram. I'm happy to answer questions on a one-to-one basis. But again, guys, I'm asking for a contribution if that's what you're asking for. And PayPal information is down below. Make a £1 contribution, and then I can answer you directly in respect of fragrance recommendations or things of that nature. But all in all, guys, see you soon in the next video. And again, be safe out there. Peace.